Hello guys, and welcome to this video. In this video, I am going to give you my personal opinions on Star Wars Battlefront 2. And I won't be doing this alone. My friend Michael is here with me today. How are you doing, Michael?
Yeah, I'm good, man. Good.
Now, Star Wars was a very anticipated game. Can we say that?
I can say it because I was looking forward to its release greatly, for sure.
But then, up until the beta, you know, the beta sort of ruined the game to an extent. And we'll talk in more detail about this and why we're saying this. Now, it was at that point, you know, during the beta, that people started disliking the game. And you might be wondering why. Like, why are people disliking the game? Well, Star Wars is one of the first few games that come with the quotation mark, you know, season pass free method. I mean, this sounds really good and all, but the microtransaction and the progressive system is what seriously hurt the game, in my opinion. Because we all saw the microtransaction sort of problems Star Wars had, and EA, they had to sort of take out the microtransaction off the game. What do you think?
Microtransactions through gaming is a problem, full stop. But obviously, a huge franchise like Star Wars, you can't get that wrong.
No, absolutely. Come on, it was, this game was so anticipated. Everyone was waiting for it. People could not wait to get, you know, hold of this game, and then they dropped this sort of microtransaction bomb, and we're stuck with this sort of mess. Now, microtransactions were literally paid to win, and in regards to leveling, the leveling system, you needed to get about 30,000 credits to unlock a hero. Now, as you're gonna see from the gameplay in the background, I'm not a very high level. I'm out around level 6, whatnot, in the gameplay. And you'll be able to see that I am already able to get Dark Vader in the end as a superhero. I'm able to unlock him after this game. Now, this is because they've cut this 30,000 credits to 15,000. Now, me and Michael were having a conversation the other time, talking about, you know, what really is grinding. As Michael mentioned, is that, you know, if you enjoy the game, you'll be playing and putting the hours into it. So grinding, you know, is really, you know, what you feel like it is. What do you think, Michael?
Yeah, my perception of language, you know, I love language, is that grinding is used by kind of just the mass media and the mobs online. There's a way of discrediting a game in some way, shape or form. Grinding is playing, they're the same thing. So if you play for 6 hours, you're not grinding for 6 hours, you're enjoying your gameplay and you're playing. It's only a grind if the game is terrible.
Absolutely, I do agree what you mean, thank you very much. Now, graphically, the game looks stunning. There's no doubt about that. The game looks amazing. And you can see the developers put a lot of time into the game. You know, as touches are very high quality. And I need to admit, the colors are very well picked and they look and work very well together. And they do give you that sort of Star Wars feel. They do, like, literally reassemble the Star Wars theme, which is really nice. Also, another thing, graphical, the cutscenes are very detailed and pretty much look somewhat like the trailers we have seen. Because, you know, most games that come out, you see a trailer looking very nice, and then when it comes to the actual console, or the PC for example, it doesn't look as good, or the textures are not so good. Well, with Star Wars, they look exceptionally great, and I'm very happy with that. In regarding to the campaign, the campaign is only about 5 to 6 hours long, but some people have also said that they finished in about four and a half hours. Now, if you are a real Star Wars fan and you want to play you know, as one of your favorite characters into the campaign, don't you think, you know, this sort of short campaign is quite bad compared to other games like Call of Duty, even though it doesn't have, you know, the best of campaigns, has about 8 hours long campaign. What do you think?
Again, this is one of those weird things of more and more games are being pushed towards multiplayer experiences, so it could be in the future that, well, not even in the future, now, games are being sold with no single player campaign. So I think this is a preference thing as to whether you as a player want to play on your own or whether you are totally multiplayer first.
Absolutely, no, I agree with that. That's very true. Unfortunately, now gaming companies are all going towards a multiplayer because that's what really hooks people up, isn't it? You might play the campaign once, like, okay, I'm done with the campaign, what do I do? You know, when with the multiplayer, you got that thing, you know, of going back to on a daily, you know, like, oh, I need to get my challenge done, oh, I need to get this, oh, I'm nearly close, you know, to getting, I don't know, 20,000 credits to unlock this. So it's always, it's that sort of, you know, involvement that it gives you, like, makes you feel, you know, interested into the game.
That's one of the weird things about when people use the word grind, is exactly that. You're looking at challenges and saying, I want to complete challenges. You're looking at stuff you want to do, and you're like, oh, I want to get that gun or whatever else. That is the grind, but that is playing the game. Like, you can't... People are too impatient. They just kind of turn up to Star Wars and go, I want to be Luke Skywalker. Of course you do. But if they just gave you Luke Skywalker in the beginning, what would you have to achieve? Where would you go from there? Like... That's, you know, we need game development, and you have to give people an arc. You have to give people something to work towards. And if it's not Luke Skywalker, what is it?
That's very true. Absolutely. Also, in terms of the sounds they are very well made. I need to admit, even in the menus, you know, you hear all this lovely orchestra. You hear all the sort of instruments, it's really nice, and it really pumps you up for the games coming. You know there's going to be some sort of major, you know, war happening. Now, talking about the actual multiplayer, as we were saying, the maps, they are amazing. They are massive, they're huge. You can use, you know, robots, you can use all sort of vehicles, you can be soldiers, you can be all sort of things. They are huge, you can do many things, but there's not a great selection of them. Now, some people say this is because all of the maps are going to come with the free DLC, which, fair enough, it's free, so technically it's not doing what other games are doing, is give you a portion of the game and then say, oh yes, it'll come, you know, in the DLC. Make sure you go and buy it. At least here it's free, but we don't know yet any details on what the DLC is going to bring. What do you think about this sort of?
This one's an interesting one. So it's a case of, do games companies withhold material to sell as DLC, and has Star Wars, to make their free DLC seem better, withheld maps they could have released at launch? Just to make their DLC seem more generous than what it actually is. I don't know, because I don't know how long it takes to make the maps. If the maps are really large and detailed, maybe they could only make three by the time they got to game release. But, you know, cynical kind of view is, you know, did they need to withhold for DLC is the thing.
Absolutely. Okay. Just the last few things I would like to add to this video. One of them is the text and the sort of menu. It's all fuzzy and out of focus. It's very annoying to look at. It literally makes you feel sick. You've played the beta. What do you think about that?
Sorry, I'm stuttering because I'm trying to think of the best way to phrase that. So, when you're looking at EA, you're looking at large productions, Frostbite engine, all these kind of bits and pieces and blah blah. Text is surely one of the most basic things.
Absolutely.
So it's annoying on a simplicity level. Like, it doesn't affect my overall enjoyment of the game, doesn't affect my overall kind of experience per se, but you do look at it and just think that's something day one you should just get right. Someone in the design team should have just sorted that instantly.
Absolutely, man. Another thing, one thing I like about Star Wars, and I'm glad they've implemented it, is the Starfighter Assault. It's the game mode where you know, play as the Star Destroyers and whatnot, and you just have to destroy other spaceships. So it's not really, you know, shooting people. It's more like, you know, being a spaceship, controlling it, and, you know, sort of getting kills with it, which is, you know, different and adds variety to the game. And I think that pretty much sums up this review. The game is good, I believe, but it needs some improvement, especially in the multiplayer progression system. As I said, you are able to get the characters you want, but it's just that, you know, sort of mark of like 15,000 and whatnot, which some people are extremely against. But 15,000, you know, for a level 6 player is not too bad. So I don't think, you know, it should go any lower. But maybe give more XP per game, if that makes sense. Though I think that will make that will fix this sort of issue, so people won't be complaining too much. Anyway, thank you very much, Maburoshi, for joining us in this sort of live review. And I'm going to let the gameplay sort of carry on. There is a 40 plus kill gameplay in the background, so I hope you enjoyed that. And me and Michael shall see you in the next one. Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Explosive offline. Clones retaking the west turbo tank.
I have been waiting.
An ally has joined the battle. Droid must fight. You require a memory wipe.
What are you looking at? I know what I'm doing.
Republic hero on site.
Final arming sequence started. West Juggernaut destruction imminent. Phase 2 complete, 20% behind schedule. Swiftly eliminate clone squads and prepare for phase 3. Beginning final phase. Detonate the front and rear fuel pipes before the cruiser launches. It must never leave Kashyyyk intact. Down initiated. Defend the front fuel pipes.
Rear fuel pipes, set for demolition.
I prefer to take you alive.
Yeah.